Patrick Cook here, fractal artist, starving fractal artist. Anyway, welcome to the second session of our project-oriented tutorial concerning Mandelbulb 3D software. So, in the first session, I was talking about what we're attempting to do here. And that would be to pursue the creation of a Mandelbulb animation that is high detail, high quality, all the way out to the point of it being rendered and being able to be presented as a finished project. And that as we go through that, project, we'll touch on the various points of the Mandelbulb 3D software. We'll probably wind up touching on 90%, well, 80% of the functionality of the Mandelbulb software. And the reason I say it's that high, 80, possibly even 90%, is because there's a variety of different development sequences that you go through to create a Mandelbulb animation. Now, I'm not talking about just doing some stills. I'm talking about a full-fledged animation, a 4K animation, complete with a soundtrack, which would require other tools. But you need to create the graphic, you do that by combining formulas and manipulating the properties of the formulas. You need to install the lighting. All right, so there's the lighting, and then of course there's the keyframes to get to your animation, and then of course there's the rendering. So where the frames are interpolated between the keyframes, and then they're laid down as files, and then you use a video editor to be able to bring all of these frames in, so where you get the motion. So what's involved with this project is the development of the graphic, the lighting of the graphic, the animation or the keyframes, and then of course the rendering. So that's a lot of territory to cover, and I think that as we go through each of those steps, we'll wind up covering discussing most of the Mandelbulb software functions and features. All right, now speaking of the Mandelbulb software, let's fire it up and let's start taking a look at our tool set. All right, so what I'm using is version 1.9.9.37. Now this was released March. Let's see here. I've got a somewhere here. I had here. Okay. This is the official website for the Mandelbulb 3D software. All right, and that I highlighted the address. Now, this is our current release. This is the one that we're using here in this project, and you can get this by downloading it. Follow the instructions to install it. It's no big deal. It's quite capable, and it's not the software structure itself is not taxing on your computer. All right. So now over on the About page, the current manager of the software provides a little bit of history. This goes back to 2010, when a user of the Fractal forums, along with some assistance from various members of the forum, created this Mandelbulb 3D software, which is really based upon the Mandelbrot, where they introduce a spatial coordinates in order to get a three-dimensional graphic. All right, and that goes back even further. But in 2010, this software was originally conceived and developed by a community, and then in 2015, it was taken over by the current manager of the software, and he made the source code available up on GitHub. So the Mandelbulb software, Mandelbulb 3D software, is essentially 13 years old, something like that. And here is the updates that it's received. Nothing really earth-shaking, I should say. There was several features that were installed that were very useful, but from what I've noticed, I've been using the Mandelbulb 3D software probably since 2015. That's when I first fired it up and said, "Whoa, okay," you know. And then in 17, of course, I was busy doing other things, you know, work and everything. But in 17, I created an animation, and it was fun. But I didn't really get back into it until about a year ago, when I decided to get back into it, because I knew that it was very powerful in terms of being able to create high resolution renderings. But anyway, take a look at this, look over this website here, all right? Download it for yourself, follow the instructions, very simple to do. The software does not require any activation, serial codes, nothing like that. There's no subscription involved. You don't have to, it doesn't call home, it doesn't check for anything. It really is old style software. From a 2010 era, where they really didn't even have the kind of resources for the software to be licensed on a usage basis. Okay, you get what you get. Don't expect a whole lot of updates. It is buggy. It does have some caveats you need to be aware of. It does crash from time to time. There's ways of being able to get some really good quality work out of old software. And of course, 2010, 13-year-old software is like ancient stuff. But the Mandelbulb 3D software is very, very, very powerful once you get to know how to use it and you leverage it for your own benefit. Okay, so that's enough for this session. What we're going to do is we're going to pick this up in the next session, and I'll give you a general idea how the Mandelbulb 3D software is laid out. And again, now, this is a project-oriented tutorial series. And so what I want to do here is not get all bogged down and talking about every little detail before you do anything. I want to actually be able to work toward a project. And of course, this is the idea that I have for this project. I want to be able to fly through this environment. twists and turns and dives, and I want to do all that kind of stuff. But that'll take time to develop all of that. So stick with me. Stick with me on this. This isn't going to be instant gratification. However, I think that by the time we're done, you'll be able to follow this. We'll go slow enough where you'll be able to replicate the things that I'm doing here for yourself. So you might want to take a few minutes and download this Mandelbulb 3D software. Get yourself geared up to be able to follow along. Be patient. Expect to get into some details. Expect to move along. And I think we're going to have a good time in discussing this project using the Mandelbulb 3D software. All right, so enough for now. I'll see you in the next session. I'll see you then.